Noble injured here, 2v2, Golgotha Depths, blue team. Couple of Space Marine players first up. Yellow Submarine is an Apothecary support commander that fights in melee combat. By default begins with a targeted heal and a passive health regeneration aura. Some Blood Ravens on show alongside Debuger is a force commander, very good offense, fights in melee combat, can also tank, disrupt and support with buffs. Over on the red team, HansMoleman is an Eldar Warlock, a melee commander that leaps into combat, some awesome disruption and mobility, can also tank damage, deal damage and chuck you a round of spells. He's annoying. And rounding off this red team is JusTfly as a Plague Champion, starts off range combat, damage of a time bolter, can't get melee weapons, some decent utility and support, can build turrets and repair, but is very slow moving around. Golgotha Depths then. Said it many times before, but it's a bit of an odd 2v2 map. Doesn't mean it's bad, but you've got this situation where both teams have a very natural, one very natural power each, but all the other powers on the map are very, very contested, running across the middle, as you can see there. Also, the Eastern team seems to have a slight advantage in that they have this raised platform to put setup teams and stuff late game, though you do see the Western team win reasonably often, so I'm not sure how much difference that is making in actuality. I mean, it's not like it's impossible to counter things that are set up there. Just have to jump on them or shoot them down with snipers. Debugger's tactical marine has been chased down and jumped on by the Warlock. Force commander using his battle cry to try and disrupt him. Tactical marine is going to now turn and engage. Banshees though still on the prowl. Howling Banshees, of course, set to get a passive charge leap in the next update. These guys are going to be jumping on you. They won't knock you over, and they will no longer have a melee charge, so they're actually going to be worse, a hell of a lot worse actually, at chasing things down, which is a little bit toxic at the moment, since they're going to chase you across the map and finish off your squads and stuff, which is not fun to play against really. So they're going to be leaping into combat, allow them to switch directions and close the distance really quickly on that leap, but they can't chase nearly as well. 490, 456, but we're here and now, and we are with Banshees with their crazy melee charge. HansMoleman now with some Rangers on the way for the carry, getting ganged up on by Heretics and Chaos Space Marines. Looks like JusTfly is using the Word Bearers DLC recolored black, looking pretty cool as you can see. 477 to 456, grenade going off on the garrison. Tactical Marines still in there. Banshees waiting for them to get out, and they're just going to get absolutely owned when they do. They need some support here. Havoc's moving up even. Node being taken out. Meanwhile, towards the south of the map, we have Debuger pushing forward and trying to decap stuff. Tactical Marines here have taken, or at least decapped, that wreck point. Tactical Marines, of course, capping 50% faster and decapping 50% faster than normal. Banshees now backing off. Did not like the assault marines showing up. Oh no, tactical marines dropping models out of the garrison. Need to get out of there. They drop one model then. Reasonably unlucky to do so maybe. Havoc's capping mid. And tactical marines caught in the crossfires of dire avengers. And now Banshees chasing them down. There is the fleet. No, that wasn't Flea, that was their melee charge kicking in. Now they're chasing down those tactical marines, but they stopped chasing them. Banshees actually have a bunch of kind of synthetic modifiers so that they don't wreck stuff so badly in retreat. They have, I think they do 30% less damage to retreating squads. And that's going to be reverted. There's no longer going to be those synthetic countermeasures for their crazy retreat performance once they get the melee leap and lose the melee charge. Banshees losing models there, or losing a model I should say. Force commander can do a good job on them with his battle cry, but you need to be able to hit that battle cry, and of course since they have fleet they can choose those engagements quite well. 449 441, most likely going to see the merciless switchblade from a warlock. You would expect it in a way, up against assault marines. Assault Marines getting away without a model loss. Yellow Submarine has lost his scouts, but he does have Devastators and Assault Marines of his own. Havoc's in the garrison. 438-441. Raptors on the field for JusTfly. There they are. Complete. Jump troops with chainswords and bolt pistols, and these guys suppress when they land, whereas Assault Marines will knock you over when you land. Pros and cons for each. Raptors can suppress in a huge area, especially since they also suppress on that little secondary leap that they do. Whereas Assault Marines knocking you down basically prevents you from doing anything and punishes you for retreating after your knockdown, and encourages you to just retreat right out as soon as they jump, since you won't get knocked down if you're retreating and they land on you. Tactical Marines looking for cover, are they? No, happy to stay behind the Devastator cover for now. Some Nurgle worship healing up those CSM. Lot of fighting over this northern power node. Meanwhile, south, the south power node is being repaired by scouts. They have shotguns, it looks like. Help keep those Banshees at bay. Assault Marines jumping in. This is Yellow Submarine doubling the south against HansMoleman. He does realize in time and only loses a single Howling Banshee. How is JusTfly going to respond? He's going to respond by coming mid and defending the power, which they assume the blue team is going for here. He didn't actually take down the node. Oh, there it goes. 386-441. Still Devastators in this garrison. So Yellow Submarine has his Apothecary and Assault Marines here. There's a jump on the Havocs. Aspiring Champion Heretics there to counter-initiate. But that was a staggered jump. There you see the Raptor jump, though. And these guys doing 30 DPS melee can tear stuff down reasonably well. Assault Marines jumping out, but they do lose a model there. 378-441. Havoc's taken a garrison to defend. Lots of garrisons on this map. Tactical Marines, got a retreat through Howling Banshees. And don't lose a model. Grenade. One of them was a little bit late, but they do get one of the models. Maybe lucky to get away with just one loss there, those Tactical Marines. 378-431. Everyone's tier 2 or going tier 2. And we have a Whirlwind and a Razorback on the way for the Space Marine players. These Devastators in a really strange position, since that garrison will shot block, and they're just going to get jumped here. Raptors getting inside the garrison. I'm pretty sure that was a misclick there. 378-420. Very, very strange. Yeah, Raptors did not mean to get in there. Whirlwind doing its thing now. Disruptive artillery vehicle. Needs to be steel to fire, but will disrupt over a large area. Not the most accurate thing, though. Can it hit those Heretics? Yes, it can. 375-420 can be very annoying to deal with. Here's the Razorback. Support vehicle for Space Marines allows them to reinforce their infantry off it, get inside and transport them around. Can hide from the Banshees in it, perhaps, who do not have an aspect. They do have a lot more health out the gate these days than they used to. And he gets through tier 1 without an aspect. He has a guarded weapon team going straight for the Bright Lance to try and quickly deal with that. Razorback can then use the Beam Scorch. Plague Champion being very cheeky and decapping the natural victory point there. 361-414. Eldar, or I should say HansMoleman, the Eldar player, putting two gens up mid. Usually you'll see gens on the south VP and kind of nowhere else, but we see some mid right now. But the Space Marines have taken it and stolen it. JusTfly has not purchased anything in tier 2 yet, apart from a Raptor Aspiring Champion. There you see him, Power Fist and Melter Pistol. Does he have Aspiring Champion for CSM? No. Webway Gate in his HQ though, to help him out. Bright Lance bashing power alongside Double Dire Avengers and the Warlock, who did not get the Merciless Witchblade up. Maybe he wants the Witchblade of Kurnus. He's got Cloak of Shadows on the way. Great support for Banshees, potentially. Apothecary with the Axe. Anointed Power Axe is called. And Purification Rites on the way. These things are set to get a buff. They're going to do 25 damage and knockback instead of, I think, the 15 that they do now. That's going to be pretty nasty. Doesn't sound like a lot, 25 damage, but you're potentially hitting every model in the squad and getting a knockback off of that as well. So you're going to follow that up with more, most likely, melee attacks. Blade Champion caught by a whole bunch of chainswords and a power axe and is forced to retreat. Now Blue Team pushing forward with double tactical marines from Debuger. I think he used a drop pod, did he? There it is. Drop tactical marines on the field. 361, 331. I thought they were going to get the triple, but Hans has decap mid and is looking for a flank maybe. He needs to be careful with his Banshees. He's gone for Aspect of Strength quickly out in tier 2 and the Exarch with her spear. Execution of weapon, it says in the tooltip. 51 DPS heavy melee on that single squad, the Exarch. The Assault Marines jumping in. Space Marine is able to turn and react quickly, but they are going to get sandwiched here between the Eldar and the Chaos. And the Heretics with their, I think it's a plasma damage Doom Blast, puts Touch of Nurgle a little bit too late. Knocks back the Force Commander though. Now going after the Apothecary, who is gaining energy with each hit of that Power Axe. Going to go down in retreat though, and is probably going to need to repurchase or use Laramans from there. Might be tricky for Debuger to go and revive. Red Team have taken the Blue Team's natural again. What is doing that? Is it those Rangers? Razorback doing work. Whirlwind has pushed forward enough to hit on this raised platform here. Raptors might go after it with their Power Fist. Rear Armor is right there waiting for the Metal Pistol getting in shots. As you see there, and they do have the energy for a jump. It's a 65 energy jump. No, they don't, in fact. Now they do. Still level 1. Raptors really do benefit a huge amount from their first level. Allows them to jump the second time that bit quicker. There's a jump. Where's it going? Very strange jump there. 361, 320. It's a no-cap game. Tier 3 for Debuger. Doesn't quite have the red to get out Terminators or any... Oh! Gone for a Terminator Force Commander. There we go. Down goes the... No! Razorback lives! I keep forgetting to check how much piercing damage this Terminator Force Commander does, but it's a hefty amount. He also has the 85 DPS Power Fist, which are all nice and good stats. He's also suppression immune, good chunk of hit points, and can retreat, which are all fine and dandy. The reason he's not used is that he doesn't really fulfill a role any better than his regular war gear does. I mean, you've got the fantastic anti-melee and general disruption of the Thunderhammer, or you've got the anti-large target of the Power Fist, or the support options of the other weapons. And it's like, what do you need this Terminator Force Commander for? Is it just tanky killiness? Maybe it is. Can get some lightning claws and stuff. Pretty decent assault cannon as well. But it's not like he's not killy with his other war gear. Stone Guard veterans using their crafting rounds, shooting at the Plague Champion, but he just used Pestilence Strike. He's got Pestilence, Armor of Pestilence, and Icon of Nurgle, but goes down. No! Takes down the Apothecary, sorry. He's level 2 now. Icon of Nurgle against double Space Marines. Not a build you see all that often. It's not bad or anything, but I think, pretty sure, does it tell me? Doesn't tell me, but I'm pretty sure it's piercing damage, which will be mitigated versus all the heavy and super heavy infantry armor of Space Marines. It's not a huge amount of damage either. 307, 317. What is this Razorback up to? Did not want to back away through the Dire Avenger for some reason and gets caught by Banshees. So, so quick. Dark Creepers on the field for HansMoleman. Inferno PvP damage really good at melting heavy and super heavy infantry from decent range as well. They can also suppress with their pinning fire, so they do offer you some utility. Stone Guard veterans switching to Vengeance rounds to shoot down the node. It looks like they want to steal it. Oh no, Havoc's with an auto cannon. Dangerous, so dangerous. Look at the damage. Wow. And now Assault Marines is getting caught by Raptors. They have to jump the hell out of there. Devastator is pushing up. Might go for the garrison. Yes, they will. Really nice garrison this, because you have 360 vision all the way around. A lot of the garrisons in the game are kind of strategically blocked by some kind of shot blocker somewhere, so you can approach it a lot easier and counter it. But this one, it's like, screw you, you can't approach me. I'm gonna shoot you from everywhere. 301, 302. Plasma cannon on the way for Debuger. Looks like he's lost. He lost his razor back. Did he lose anything else? Yeah, I think he lost tactical marines along the way. He's got Stern Guard veterans now, but he had double tacks at one point. Completely missed that as usual. Fail. Webway from HansMoleman to get his forces into the middle quicker. And it's a 2-1 for red, and blue team have to break this down. Pretty tough to go after the natural there. You can flank around, but then if you're discovered and retreat through a bunch of stuff, it can be painful. Whirlwind in a good position. A pretty good map for the Whirlwind. Look how far away it is from the action. It's getting shots. 274. 302. Importantly, the Whirlwind does not knock back or damage or hit friendly units, so you don't need to worry about that. Blue team are going for some kind of push. Slaughter up on the CSM. Could be a big engagement here. There's some Nurgle worship. Plague champion going straight after the apothecary. Got way too close. Not sure why the plague champion used pestilence strike there. Players seem to use it offensively a hell of a lot, but they forget that they're granting loads of range damage resistance to the thing that they just used it on. Use it to finish things off or use it to defend yourself, I think, is a bit better. Oh, Force Commander Terminator teleporting in to use the Heavy Flamer, which is a trick he can do, which the regular Force Commander can't. Just a whole load of area of effect damage over time. Kind of area denial. You need to move out of that or you're just going to take so much damage. Gets away as well. 236, 302. JusTfly reinforcing stuff at base. Yellow submarine floating quite a lot. Might be going for a Land Raider Redeemer here. Always risky against Eldar. But Hans has no red whatsoever. Been using Distort Field a lot or something. And his webways, I suppose. Plasma Cannon, I think. Yeah, got a shot on those Rangers. There it goes again. Smack destroys the shield. Banshees coming out of infiltration thanks to the Cloak of Shadows and Witchbread of Kurnus. It's going after the garrison with it. Ethereal Slash. Oh, here comes the Whirlwind though. Heart of Darkness also is up. That's being completely reworked for the new update. That's going to be a straight up support ability rather than making the Warlock super tanky. 200, 302. Double plasma cannons getting shots in. Oh, some friendly fire there. Plasma cannons get so much friendly fire in general. Some Nurgle worship top. You might want to think about getting a Nurgle shrine up there. Vanguard veterans with their two power swords, lightning claw and thunder hammer, causing all sorts of havoc. Look at this. Raptors have gone for melter guns for a reason I'm not too clear on. Usually you'll wait to see vehicles hit the field before you get these melter guns up, but they've gone for them, doing a lot of damage to that Force Commander. As you can see, they do lose the ability to fight effectively in melee combat though, and they also don't suppress on landing anymore, as you can see there, which is a big loss from their repertoire. But they do get some really awesome anti-vehicle capabilities or anti-large target in general. Yellow submarine calling in some Terminators, as did Debugger. 187, 286. Wow, Space Marine is starting to ramp up into tier 3 now. All of a sudden, two Terminator squads on the field. They are looking so, so dangerous. JusTfly. Did he not get anything out in tier 2? I don't think he did. He just upgraded stuff and went straight to tier 3. Maybe he wants the Great Unclean One. He's got a lot of power. Oh no, he did finish the cap. There we go. Kitted out his Plague Champion, is level 3. Hasn't done a huge amount for him yet. 187, 247. Maybe would have been better off spending a bit less on the sword and aggressively go after the Assault Marines and Vanguard Veterans. Force Commander getting stuck in retreat there and does go down. Had trouble pathing around those Banshees. Wow. Smack. Power Fist, or Plague Fist I should say, wiping out those Stone Guard veterans. Just as I said, it hasn't done a whole lot for him. It does that. Was he not paying attention there? I certainly wasn't paying attention. I don't know what the heck happened. TSM with Eternal War Markers each and Aspiring Champion level 3 doing so much damage, but just outnumbered there. Got them in a really bad position. Cloak of Shadows doing its thing. Look at that. That is scary. Auto Cannon getting shots on the Space Marine Terminators. Vanguard Veterans in retreat. Plasma Cannon, a real pain in the ass. Eldar, of course, don't have any jump troops apart from the Autark, I suppose, who can leap on stuff. Oh, Rangers go down. Just about to say, could disrupt with Kinetic Pulse or Kinetic Shot, whatever it's called, but they went down. 187-204. Whoa, Witchbread of Kurnus wrecking stuff in retreat. Banshees, though, unable to finish off that squad. Unfortunately for them, Fire Prism is up from HansMoleman, and that Autocannon has such an amazing vantage point. Lots of damage to the Terminators. Hasn't taken a model yet. What's going on back here? Vanguard Veterans catching Double Dire Avengers. There's the Fire Prism. Grenade on the Havocs. Scouts were sacrificed to get that grenade off. Is it going to... No, almost led to a squad wipe. But Fire Prism comes in with its dispersed shot and disrupts. Oh, does go down. Terminators using their teleport really well there. Stormbolt was finishing it off. Pestilent Strike used to allow the Plague Champion to close the distance. Goes after the Terminators. They did not want to lose a model, so run away. Or teleport away, I should say. Terminators never run away, unless you're the Force Commander. Great Unclean One on the way for JusTfly, but is it going to be enough? Wow, down goes a Whirlwind. Is that why they got it? To hunt down the Whirlwind? Well, it worked. They're level 3 now, and they're going to try and decap. Well, here come Vanguard Veterans. Don't want to fight those guys at all. And they do get out. Debugger has lost quite a lot. The Terminator Force Commander is actually the first unit in his roster again. That's how much stuff he's lost. Banshee is catching him on retreat. He's burned down a hell of a lot of power, that's for sure. Tried to even decap there and is going to get away. The Terminator Force Commander cannot level up as Raptors just about making it out. 2 hit points, seriously? They're going after them, but I don't think they're going to be able to do this. Resident Strike shuts that down quickly. 187-140. Howling Banshees with Distort Field up on them from the Warlock's Global Bar. Debugger now down to Vanguard Veterans and Terminators. Got a Predator Tank on the way. Great Team 1 just about to hit the field. Just see this big fella walk out of there. Where is he? There he is. Super Unit for Chaos. A greater demon, so you can worship this guy for huge benefits. Has some nasty abilities, but can be very energy intensive. That's why he has a consume ability. Can basically just eat a allied model to get some energy back. Usually poor heretics are the target of that consume. Would be cool if there was a kind of an eat animation for it, but I suppose that would take too long. And a basically just disappear into nothingness. They're consumed into warp energy. Plague Champion using the Plague Fist, which is an amazing capping tool, so that is another reason to get it on this map and any map, I suppose. 187-111. Eldar pushing alongside the Great Unclean One. Vanguard Veterans jumping out. Predator Tank trying to keep its distance. Is it going to switch to Las Cannons? Not yet, in a way. Fire Prism also using its range. 65 range those things have. Insane. Whoa! Plasma Cannon getting a really juicy shot on a full stack of CSM and Raptors. It's really kicking off in a bit though. There's a Great Clean One with its Nurgle Vomit type stuff. Banshees have been used so well by Hans. Just dipping in and out of engagements, chasing things down. And it's going to finish off this Force Commander, I think. Yes. Are those ladies level 4? Level 3.5. Grand Clean One is, wow, causing all sorts of problems. That was a foul snare, which stunned an entire army there. There's Cloud of Flies. needs to be careful. Not invulnerable, this guy. Over 6,000 hit points of super heavy infantry armor, but he can be taken down, especially if isolated like that. No longer has his splash damage, of course, but does, I think it's 240 damage heavy melee per hit. So he's still really going to hurt you. There's the cleansing flame. Or is that just the basic attack of the flamer? Might have just been the basic attack. Vanguard veterans dropping a model thanks to the warlock, who's level 6. 154. Triple one. It's havoc's on the way for JusTfly. HansMoleman has some Seer Council. Can now support Seer Council and Banshees with his Cloak of Shadows and Distort Field. And of course the Seer Council themselves grant a passive buff that will affect the Banshees. So a lot of synergistic support going on there. Plague Chaplain runs into a power axe. Doesn't end well. 139 now for the blue team on VPs. And they get the middle back though. What is that? Is the Force Commander Terminator trying to cap? Is he going to foul snare him off the cap there? Not in time to stop the decap, that's for sure. Seer Council leaping in, and that leap knocks down and does damage, I believe. And as they all leap in, that can really rack up, and it's a really good alpha strike. Tactical Marines taken down by foul snare. The damage on that is delayed by like a second or so for some reason, so you think you've got away from it, but no, the damage kicks in and you're down. 130, triple one. Hectic stuff in mid. Nurgle Shrine now helping out the red team greatly, allows them to reinforce if it's being worshipped, which is not at the moment. Actually not repairing it either. Those heretics need to get to work. Why did he full retreat out there? Not sure. Now, there they go. They're now worshipping the shrine, so everything can reinforce off it. The heal also goes off more often, I believe. And the suppression goes off more often. It will suppress nearby enemies. Terminator squad down to a single model. Great, and Kuma's done a really good job so far without worship support. If you're worshipping the shrine, you're not doing regular Nurgle worship. 130, triple one. Cloud of flies, but he eats a melter bomb. He'll be okay. Might want to take him back to base and worship him there. Otherwise, that's going to be a really long time to get him back to full health. Obviously, they want to keep the mid. More Terminators for Debugger here. Land Raider Redeemer on the way for Yellow Submarine. That could be a massive game changer. JusTfly does have a nuke, but HansMoleman does not. Jumping in are the Vanguard veterans. What level are these guys? Very near level 3. Going to hit level 3 here. Surely there it is. Going to wipe out the heretics as well. So no worship support for JusTfly. Needs to get more heretics up. Loses his havocs as well. Vanguard veterans wrecking face. Down goes a whirlwind again. Raptors doing a fantastic job taking those things out. Level 4. Really good aggressive jumps into the western side of the map to take those things down. Oh, good grief. Six power fists on retreat will do that. And there's an Imperial Fist, Imperial Abyss, I should say, not an Imperial Fist. That'll be crazy. Just a massive power fist comes up and smacks you in the ass. Terminators did lose a bunch of models there. Look at those Dark Reapers. Force Spawner Terminator just about gets away. These guys are heavy infantry, so they do have some resistance to the piercing damage of those Storm Bolters. But yeah, that Raptor loss was bad for JusTfly. He had a really topsy-turvy couple of minutes. Lost Heretics, lost Havocs, took down the Whirlwind, and then lost his Raptors. Some tight retreat paths escaping from the west side, as you can see. Not quite so harsh escaping from the east side. Land Red Redeemer hits the field. Could be a massive deal. Red team have taken the blue team's natural though. Where's that Land Raider? There it is. Gonna make its way to the middle, I would assume. Unless he gets really ballsy and takes it all the way around the northern edge and tries to camp that VP, but I very much doubt it. More Havocs with Mark of Corn for JusTfly. HansMoleman is floating resources like crazy. Could get an... Oh, he's pop cap. That's why he can't actually purchase anything else. As soon as he loses something significant, he can get an avatar immediately, or start getting one anyway. Plasma Cannon charging up. Hits the Dark Creepers, but does not take him. One of those guys almost level 3. CSM able to fight under the protection of that Pestilent Strike cloud of filth, but are eventually forced off. Now they know that a Land Raider Redeemer is there, surely. Are they all going to bunch up on this ramp, though? Look at this. Three Terminator squads, Terminator Force Commander, Vanguard Veterans, Land Raider Redeemer, Apothecary Support. They have ramped up. Land Raider Redeemer is set to get some adjustments. I think a speed boost, but it's going to heal less often. Like half as often, I think. I think it's every half a second at the moment, and that's going to be changed to every second. 53, 111, orbital bombardment from one of the Space Marine players, catching some Eldar stuff, catching the Banshees pretty much flush. He needs to retreat. He's not using retreat, which would reduce the damage, but they are level 4, right? Yes, so they do survive it. Look at this push, though, by the Space Marines, chasing down the Great and Clean One. Turret's not going to last long. It's taken out. Foul Snare on the Apothecary. Great and Clean One trying to take him out, but he's risking a lot. Massive risk here. JusTfly in trouble. Really is in trouble. If he loses this Great and Clean One, he's down to just CSM. 37. Triple One. Blue team needs to get some VPs going. What is this? Very sneaky. Dire Avengers are going to finish the cap on Blue Team's Natural. They're obviously pushing hard against Red Team's Natural. Wow, the Grand Clean One got away. Was not expecting that. Eats a Melter Bomb, but should be fine. Hobbling into base. The Plague Champion is down. Level 5. Webway Gate there. Oh, he's going to chase it in with Terminators and the Assault Marines. It's not going to be fine, I don't think. He's in base now. Yes, he's okay, I think. I have no idea. HQs will heal single entities for 2% of their maximum health per tick. So he's gaining huge amounts of health, the Great and Clean One there. And he's okay. Some Nurgle Worship there as well. Survives. Blue team have taken the Red team's Natural, though. They have the triple cap, and this could be it. Avatar of Kane on the way for Hansboy. Is it going to be enough? Is it going to be enough? Where is it? There it is. Great and Clean One and Avatar might be able to push against the Land Raider Redeemer with maybe a nuke from JusTfly. Uh-oh, there's that Frag Assault absolutely wrecking those Banshees. And the Seer Council were there as well. Level 2 Seer Council, 2875 hit points. Terminator's a Land Raider. Does the job. It really does the job. Doesn't even need to reinforce all of his guys. Force Commander Terminator has switched to the Assault Cannon. Is that triple Assault Cannons? No. One Assault Cannon for the Terminators. The other squad not upgraded. 30, 13. There's a double cap, and that might be it. Not enough time, I don't think, for the Avatar or the Great and Clean One to make an impact here. No way. Game is over. 2-1 cap, but it's not going to be enough time. Warlock going for the cap. Imperial Abyss is spawned right at the end of the game, but it was the end of the game. That would have been nasty as well. Look at that. I suppose they could have all teleported out, but would have been a very interesting push if they had another couple of minutes or so there. Land Raider did the business. As soon as it came out, just a massive wave of Space Marines pushed back JusTfly, who had already lost a bunch of stuff, to be fair, and just couldn't recover in time. Look at the commanders, end of the game. Level 4 Apothecary. Force Commander Terminator. We had a level 8 Warlock and a level 5 Plague Champion. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.